Okay.
The voice of the county. BBC Somerset Sound.
It's another busy night tonight as Carnival fever hits Glastonbury. It's estimated that well over 80,000 people will line the streets of the town this evening. Indeed, police have warned of traffic problems in the area from lunchtime onwards. More than 105 entries will parade past onlookers tonight as the greatest free show on earth is with us once more.
There you go, that was James Bobbitt, the Glastonbury Town Crier, and Alan King from Winchester and Gene Wells from Blandford Forum. And this is the head of the carnival procession. This is the Avalon Marching Band. And we're going to sit back and enjoy these fine musicians from Avalon and the Avalon Marching Band. Running. the Avalon Marching Band, and they're accompanying Baton Swingers, of course. My name's Malcolm Jones. You just see me in the little caravan with my good friend and associate Brian Epps. Brian, saying good evening to the good people.
Oh, good evening, everyone, and you're very welcome at this particularly wonderful evening. Truly spectacular. This is Glastonbury and Chilkwell Carnival.
Yes, there's His Worship, the Mayor of Glastonbury, Councillor Stephanie Moreland, and Mrs. Charlotte Jones, the Carnival Chairman, and Mr. Hugh Barker. Now we're looking at the Carnival Queen. This is Miss Alice Kelly. The Queen is accompanied by her attendants, who are...
And her attendants this year are Miss Julianne Hosgood, Miss Jessica Munt, and presumably her sister, who is Natasha Munt. And they've just been crowned, actually, by Her Worship the Mayor, Councillor Stephanie Moreland.
And very lovely they look as well. Beautiful. Help the St. John's Ambulance Brigade carry on. That's the message that's been given over tonight. The money tonight collected from the carnival, of course, all goes to charity. It was a charity. It was a phenomenal amount collected last year. Brian, can you just tell me how much it actually was?
Yes, they raised an amazing £10,210, which went to lots of charities in the locality. And let's hope they can improve on that tonight.
Absolutely. From the Zigzag Carnival Club of North Petherton, and their presentation this year is In the Navy. These are all based at the Swan Inn at North Petherton. It's a juvenile entry, and it's a very, very good entry, as you will see coming up. This is the cleanest ship that ever sailed the
Ocean Blue.
The Ocean Blue.
Now, even though you might think this is a little modest entry, this actually cost over £2,000 to put on, so you can imagine the amount of money that they have to raise during the year to put on this particular float. So many congratulations to them.
Yes, and get back to swabbing those decks.
May they go on from strength to strength.
Ohar, Jim Lang.
Ohar.
We can see just tucked in now, this is one of the first walk-in entries. It's from Bridgewater. It's the Young Generation Carnival Club, and their entry this year is the Spanish Fiesta. Last year they were all in a stew. The club was formed in 1977, and they've had countless carnivalites go through their hands, and they go from this little walk-in entry into the major club to Bridgewater. So congratulations from the young to the Young Generation Carnival Club.
And they'd like to pay a special mention, or a special thank you, to Mrs. Chris Bryant, who made all the costumes. Now, that's a lot of work.
On November the 19th in 1863, Abraham Lincoln made this speech at Gettysburg, and it was the turning point of the war. He said, 47 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal.
As it turned out, some were created more equal than others, but never mind.
Absolutely. This is the interpretation of the American Civil War, the Confederate view, the rebel yell from the Crusaders Carnival Club, based in Bridgewater at the Duke of Monmouth. And here it is in all its glory. I think this was actually based on the Confederates in the early stages of the war.
Why do you say that?
Well, it looks so smart, doesn't it? Very good entry.
Yes, they do indeed.
It's the Rainbow Juvenile Carnival Club from Bridgewater, and they're all little horrors. Oh, well, that's the name of their entry, and I expect they are little horrors as well. There they go, scaring the living daylights out of the crowd. Ghosties, ghoulies, witches, devils, and all the things that go bump in the night.
That's it.
From the Wick Carnival Club, based here in Glastonbury, and their entry this year is Gulliver. Our VT editor, Nick, would like to say hello and good luck to all the Wick Carnival Club, and congratulations for getting the Chairman's Choice at Wells. Special hello to all the lovely girls on the float. especially Lynn and Vicky at the front. And look out for dandruff on Vicky's shoes. I read that, Vicky. I didn't say I read that.
He doesn't mean it. He doesn't mean it, honestly.
Yes, and also that Nick's mum is on here, so you must behave yourself. This is Gulliver, based on the Jonathan Swift novel Gulliver's Travels, of course, and this is his journey into Lilliput. And we'll try and look at the ladies on the generator because Nick's mum is on there. There's poor old Gulliver being held down by the Lilliputians.
My good friend John Cullen, who designed this particular float, said that he was going to have a go this year to do something really unusual, and they've come up trumps, I think.
There's Nick's mum, the lady in red, we believe.
Goodbye. Oh, there she is.
Oh, there she is. That's Nick's mum. Oh, bless her. She's got a lot to put up with, hasn't she? And here's a little bit of jingoistic pride now from the Limekiln Carnival Club of Bridgewater. And it's the pride and the glory. Well, what can I say about it? I'm English and proud of it. There'll always be an England. John Bull, Beef Eaters, Chelsea Pensioners, Union Jacks, all. Oh, God bless England.
Perhaps it's not surprising that this particular entry will always gain a lot of approval from the watching audience. A lot of hand clapping here. A lot of people really do appreciate this. We are a very patriotic nation.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And we don't care about Maastricht or France or any of those countries. Well, actually, I do care about Europe. There's a little bar in Menorca that I'm very partial to.
I don't think that really counts, does it?
No, I don't think so.
No, I know.
I don't think Menorca really considers it part of the EC. God bless England and God bless the Limekiln Carnival Clubs, one of the oldest clubs in the Bridgewater area. And they'll go from strength to strength. Good luck. The pride and the glory. From the Pentathlon Carnival Club, the champions for many, many years. This is their splendid entry this year. It's called El Cid, Lord of Spain. Pentathlon, of course, are based at Moreland. Last year's spectacular entry was Enchantica, Brian, El Cid.
Yes, this is set in Spain. It's a wonderful cart, this. Set in Spain in the 11th century, this was an uneasy truce between the Christians and the Moors. And one of the most powerful emirs and mountain men honored a brave knight, Rodrigo, with the title of El Cid, which is the Lord. Rodrigo lived up to his title as a noble warrior, and the scene depicts one of the many battles in a Moor's palace.
I know Pentathlon will be a little disappointed in earlier. There's El Cid himself, of course, played in the film by Charlton Heston. But as I was saying, Pentathlon, who have been champions for many years, I've got to say that this year they will not be champions. Later on, we will see the champions elect come along. As spectacular and as splendid as it is not the champion. The next entry we see is from the Newmarket Carnival Club. This is in the comic character, the comic section. It's Walk Like a Man, the Newmarket Carnival Club of Bridgewater. And these are based on... from an outrageous character called Divine, who is a man who dressed as a woman. You all must know Divine. He was in a big hit movie called Shampoo. Divine was from a character created and used in all the John Walters film until that's Divine, or supposed to be Divine. Divine unfortunately died just last year. But she was outrageous. John Walters films are all outrageous, and this card is outrageous.
Not quite as outrageous, but absolutely spectacular, is this entry from the Ramblers Carnival Club in Bridgewater. This is called American Parade.
This has so far been placed second everywhere. Will it win tonight, we wonder. These Ramblers are spectacular in everything they do.
It's all go, it's all movement, it's all light, it's pretty wonderful.
and follow the band from the show.
Barnum,
of course. There you go. Good side shot. I hope you're going to sit back, relax, and enjoy tonight's presentation brought to you by Swift TV. Tonight's director is Roy Chapman, one of the very finest, so he tells me. Here's another great entry now.
This is Clapton Carnival Club, and this is A Child's Dream, I think.
Absolutely correct. There, this is the first year they've entered as a walking group due to the upgrading and work being carried out on their trailer. They tell me they'll be back and running. This is all the characters from A Childhood Dream. Little Boy Blue, Jack and Jill Up the Hill, etc. We switch back now to Sam Vantra, one of the legends of Carnival. Sam Vantra, Let's Get Hooked, based on the film. Hook. Peter Pan, in other words. There they are, working their little selves to pieces. Spectacular fashion, as we expect from Sam Vantra. They've been the county champions for years and years and years.
And it just goes to show how sophisticated you can get a walking entry to be with wheeled props. And that, believe it or not, is a wheeled prop.
Yes, and there's a real character in the back. Unfortunately, she's in a wheelchair this year. It's one of the mums from Sam Vantra's, Tracy's mum. She usually walks around, but she's confined to a wheelchair, but she's determined to keep going, and she will.
The Mendip Vale Carnival Club, based in Wells, and their cocktail cabaret.
We still build without cover, they tell me, in a field, with loads of money and materials for a shed, but no permanent site. And they're saying that if anyone in the Wells area has some land, money's no object. Come on, get in touch with the Mendip Vale Carnival Club, and they need somewhere to build a permanent site.
Yeah, and this really is the spirit of Carnival. They have less than 20 members, and obviously everybody does just about everything. And so we applaud them, and let's hope you can help them as well.
And now we can see as it turns the corner and slowly unfolds before our eyes, we can see all the famous cocktails, all of which I have drunk in my time.
Many times. Never let it be said.
On many continents, I'm a much traveled, much drunk man. Tequila sunrise. I went to Mexico for that. A pink colada. A pina colada. That was also in Mexico.
Well, you can get that in Cleethorpes, you know, just the same.
You know, it's not the same. And a blue lagoon, which is Cointreau and whatever else they put in it. I drink that everywhere. And that's a clever, nice, clever, simple idea from the Wells, the Mendip Vale Carnival Club of Wells. We'll stay on this one for a little while. You see at the end, behind the generator, there's a tractor pushing. This is a feature that we'll see. We won't mention it again after this, but if we hang on a little bit longer, there's a tractor either end, one pulling and one pushing, because anybody who knows Glastonbury knows that it's up a very steep hill. It's slightly wet, the conditions, and so a little shove makes it all work. Okay, we're going into some walking entries now, excuse me. There's a little fireman. Do we know who this guy is? Sam, Fireman Sam. Turn around, give me your number. I think we may be able to ID this man. Brian.
Well, we reckon it's Sam Dredge.
I think it is. And Michaela Dredge.
That's right. And he's Fireman Sam, believe it or not. So he's emanating his namesake there.
Yes, thanks to Grandpa Dredge for making
And that's Maisine Bagley. from Taunton, who is Springtime in Paris.
Number 89 we're also looking at, and this is Brian Gray of Fiesta Carnival Club, Bishop's Hall. He's been taken for a ride. Last year he was Chief Sitting Bull, Wolf's Carnival Club, Hooked on Classics. These walkers come on us so quick. These were county champions last year, you may remember, with their
synchronized
swimming. That's right, this year they're synchronized orchestras. There they go. How do they drift along like that? What makes these people move, you may ask?
Very clever.
And we all recognize the music as well. What is it, Brian? That's the actual power behind Wolves Carnival Club there. That guy, the conductor, is absolutely crazy. Now we're going to look for an entry number 96. Who's coming along after Wolves. 96, she's full of Eastern promise. Her name escaped me for a little while. I'm hoping to come up with it. Yes, it's
just Claire Parker.
Thank you, Brian.
Wonderful costume.
Look at this.
Tremendous.
Yes. Yes. Claire's an old timer. She's been in Carnival for hundreds of years. From the Commercial Carnival Club of Bridgewater is let's get something or other. A Strife on the Ocean Waves, the eternal battle between Bluto and Popeye, of course. There's Popeye and Alan. And a gunship following up the rear to take care of business and sort all the trouble out. Bluto's captured Popeye's ship and the gunship's coming up behind. I don't know if we're going to have a look-see at this. There we are. There's good old Popeye on his ship and right at the front being pulled along. Oh, there's olive oil showing all our business.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my God.
And a little baby there. And
the baby is
kind of spinach above it all.
What's the name of the baby?
And the clue.
Sweet Pea.
All right then, 10 marks to you.
Thank you. Oh, I've got an old level in Popeye. The Mad Hatter's Carnival Club. They're from Wookiee, which is quite local. Oh, what a balls up. This is based on, they're all snooker balls.
Now, if it's a really cold night, this is a very sensible costume. Because basically, you're never going to get a cold midriff.
No, you're
whatever
not,
happens, you're never going to get a cold midriff.
No, you may get whacked by a cue ball. There's a piece of chalk. They're all cue balls and chalk. There's the white, which is the cue ball. The red, which is worth 1 point. There's a brown of 4 points. A green, 3 points. And a blue, 5 points. It's a sign of a wasted childhood, they tell us, the snooker.
You're so knowledgeable, Mark.
Oh, that's a very good snooker player as well. I believe that song they're playing is by all the snooker players in the circuit. Well, we're going to look now for another walking entry. It's a Spanish lady. It's number 85, if we can pick her up. There she is.
This is Tracy Cook.
Tracy Cook. Good old Tracy. She's 19 years old. She's been in Carnival for 12 years. And she's a lady, a fantasy of Spain. Well done, Tracy. We look forward to seeing you every year, Tracy. I went to Spain this year, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Jolly good.
Thank you. Menorca. That's in Spain, isn't it? It's actually off the coast of Spain. Enough of this trivial. Let's get back to
we're going to the States now.
Live in Las Vegas from the Pegasus Carnival Club. They're based in Wookiee as well. And we're going to take a long, lingering look at this because it's full of lovely-looking girls, good costumes, and great choreography. And the music of the king, Mr. Elvis Presley.
Got to give credit to the designers of this car, which is Linda Weir and Caroline Frew. And the total cost of £7,500.
Well spent.
Absolutely.
Great choreography as well. We don't know who the choreographer was, but the club captain we know is Paul Mapstone. Mapple. Excellent. I love this. I love Las Vegas. Got to go there one day.
And they say they've got the best looking girls in Carnival.
Well, we're just going to sit back and judge now. Just a moment. It'll take us a while. Yeah, she's all right. Yeah, she's all right.
Okay, Mark's had a 10 for that one.
She's all right.
I think 9 for that one, don't
you? Well, you give a 9, I give it a 10.
Okay.
Yes, we'll go along with the Pegasus Carnival Club view that they have got the best looking girls in Carnival. Great costumes. Great movement. In the past, I've been accused of being sexist, so I'm going to make no sexist comments to this evening. She gave me a lovely smile there, one of those girls. She must have thought I was someone else.
Yeah, must have made a mistake.
Fever! Oh. Elvis Presley, I ain't.
A singer, you're not either, actually.
I might be so bold as to say.
Feel free. I think you're a friend enough now. Enjoy yourself in your last carnival.
Oh, thank you.
We've got a couple of walk-in entries now. We're also desperate to try and find out. It is very, very difficult to ID the walk-in entries. Is this a 106, I believe? There's a 106, Brian. Can we spot a 106?
Yeah, this is Seal Claire.
She's a Seal. 105.
105 is Circus Tent.
Yes.
And this is Donna Marie Mellish. I think you pronounce that from Street.
Yes. She looks like a street girl. 107.
107 is Ringmaster, and this is Simon Mellish from Street as well.
They're all together.
A little family group.
That's
there.
Right, they're a nice family. The Seal, the clowns. I bet that's Martin Parr. Is it? Who's the clown? We can't ID their number, unfortunately. A good entry, a good walking entry. From the Cobra Carnival Club. They're based in Wells as well, and their entry is fire. They're based at the Fountain Inn in Wells. This is their first year in Carnival. I didn't know that. Their first year. Well, a special mention for Elsie and Paul Attica, Dave Willerton, for the help with models and costume. And thank you to Andy Hollis for being the escort vehicle. And the club designer, Mark Rowe, we're mentioning everything we can. The club captain, model maker, Andy Hine. And congratulations on your first year in Carnival. And I hope you go on from strength to strength. We shall be looking out for you next year. Yeah. Cobra Carnival Club of Wells and Fire. Brian.
Yeah, very warm welcome to them as well.
That's a very good entry there. Yes, congratulations, your first year. Here's a guy who's not his first year, it's his millionth year. This is a good old friend of mine. I don't go down and talk to him anymore. His dog bit me one year. George Brinicum. Well, that is dogs this year. George Brinicum, British Empire Medal, I believe.
This is called A Christmas Float from George, minus his dogs. He's actually bit Malcolm twice.
I don't think the dogs are actually allowed to compete at Glastonbury. But he don't mind, the dogs are here somewhere. George does a tremendous amount of work for charity. Does a lot of collections, and this is why he got his British Empire Medal. His ambition in life is to win a carnival procession. He'll probably get the award this year for longest float pulled by man walking backwards. We are now looking at the Royal British Legion Carnival Club, based in Weston-super-Mare. Their entry is the Blues Brothers, based on the film The Blues Brothers. It really is a cult movie. You've either seen the film and understand this, or you haven't seen the film, and in which case it's absolutely meaningless. The film starred John Belushi and
Dan Aykroyd.
Dan Aykroyd, thank you very much. And of course, James Brown, the legendary soul singer, blues singer. If you've never seen the film, go to your video shop. Every video shop in the world holds a collection of a couple of Blues Brothers movies.
This float actually cost £6,000. The film that it's based on cost a staggering $27 million, mainly because of the many stunts that were incorporated in it. And of course, it was a chase comedy film, so an enormous amount of money. And I don't know whether they ever got a payback on that, but this float, obviously, depicting everything that went on in the Blues Brothers film.
John Landis?
John Landis, the director.
John Landis, the director, yes. And I can only recommend this film. If you want to see the ultimate in chase movies, go and see this film. It really is great. And there's a Blues Brothers 2 film being planned now. It's being written at this moment by Dan Aykroyd. And this will be a sensation as well. Special mention on the float to Keith Wilson and Tony Chidsey. They're late members who have given all hours to build the float. And this year they're celebrating 10 years in the Royal British Legion Carnival Club. Congratulations. Happy 10th anniversary. The Temple of the Sacred Tiger. This is a presentation coming to you now, presented by the Globe Carnival Club of Wells. Last year's entry was spaced out. This is in direct contrast. And this is quite sensational. Models by Bill Dickens and Bill Baker and Mark Baker. The designer is actually Bill Baker, and I love this. I love this entry, and I love the costumes. Brian, perhaps you could tell us about it.
Yes, you know, there's something really tremendous about gold, the shimmering gold, and basically that amounts to a total of 20,000 sequins, and they're sewn on individually by hand, as they used to say on the Come Dancing program, but this is absolutely true, and this is the first year that Glad Parsons hasn't been on the cart. Glad is due a hip replacement very soon now, if she hasn't already had that. But she'll be back next year, she says. Like all good carnivalites, they keep returning.
We look forward to seeing you again next year, Glad. And I can't wait to feel Glad all over. The Temple of the Sacred Tiger from the Globe Carnival Club of Wells. Lovely girl there. She's very, very happy to be on. She's been laughing and smiling, looking at the crowd, and I'm glad that she's enjoying herself. This next entry is from the Young at Heart Carnival Club, based in Weston's Orland, which is a village just outside of Bridgewater. It's one of Brian's particular favourites, and I'm going to give Brian the privilege of talking through this. Yes, at the heart of Weston's Orland, under the sea.
Thank you very much, Malcolm. Yes, I really like this because it's a difficult subject, really, to depict in carnival sort of mode. But here it is, Under the Sea. It's based on The Little Mermaid. And the main feature is obviously a tractor with a mermaid arm, which you've seen. And the cart is divided into three parts. There are three moving turntables that you can see, shells and seahorses. And it really is very effective. There's an awful lot going on. And they've got to be imaginative with the costumes here, too. And you can see various members dressed as crabs and lobsters and fish and mermaids and octopuses and bad ladies.
I've always been confused whether it's octopuses or octopi.
Well, I'm a pussies myself.
So I've heard.
But unfortunately, they've got some lights out here, which is going to affect their overall judging. And it's a bit of a shame, but it doesn't detract actually from what you're seeing, which is a very fine entry indeed.
And congratulations to Libby Curl, the model maker. It's smoking, it's alive, it's moving, it's awesome. It's the Griffins Carnival Club of Bridgewater, one of the gigantic clubs from the Bridgewater area. This is my particular favourite club because I was one of the founder members, so if I'm prejudiced, please forgive me.
Oh, I think you are, Mark. Just a touch.
Last year their entry was Noah's Dream, which everyone rated. It didn't, unfortunately, win very much. but nonetheless it was excellent. This year is also is quite sensational. The designers Bill and Rick Richards, they go in for the large, I think is the only way to describe it. It's huge. If we can get a long big shot of this, we will. There we are, look at this thing moving along. Brian.
Yeah, every year, you know, I mean, people actually get things going round now and so on, but Griffins are always pushing the barriers on this front and on an engineering front. This is quite tremendous. There is so much movement here.
And it's all contra-rotating. It's not just going one way. It's look at this. I mean, it's quite sensational, isn't it?
And this is not winning.
Why isn't it winning, Brian? Tell me.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it really is. Look at this in your picture now. Isn't this sensational?
I think the best they've got is a joint fourth. I mean, it is a competition. They don't care. They'll go on forever doing this, but it's a competition. And you people are sitting at home in the wharf. Try and judge for yourself. See if you can pick the winner this year. We've already given you a clue that this hasn't won so far, which doesn't mean to say it won't win tonight. That's not the way it works, but for the life of me, I don't know why it's not won.
No, and you've had some beautiful shots of this too tonight. Well, let's wish them all the best and hope that they can get in the frame.
Absolutely. That's the Griffins Carnival Club of Bridgewater. A couple of walking entries coming up now, a couple of old friends, we might say. Emma Kingston is the first one, and she's a wave rider, based on a seahorse, of course, riding the waves. Little Emma.
She said it's an undiscovered species of seahorse riding the waves.
Well, it's been discovered now, hasn't it?
So nice.
The Cafe Europa. This is her dad, Bob Kingston, and his mobile cafe. I think I actually ate in there somewhere in Europe. The ultimate in greasy spoon. God, we eat some stuff when we're abroad, don't we?
Oh, we do indeed.
What a Bob, a great carnival light. Let's travel now over to the Caribbean, or as our American friends say, the Caribbean. Wherever you call it, this is where it is. The Cavaliers Carnival Club from Bridgewater. Typically tropical. I think it's fair to say this is not one of the biggest clubs in Bridgewater, but nonetheless, what they lack in fun, they make up in enthusiasm. The very last girl, 1, 2, 3, 4 on your screen, the last girl along. That's a girl making a comeback into Carnival. We've just lost her for a moment. And that's Karen. Karen Rainey. She's actually a great sport. She's been out of Carnival for a little while. She's back now. Good to see you again, Karen.
The world of the hydraulic engineer has come into play once again here. This is the Marketeers Carnival Club in your picture now. And this is called Clockwork Capers. This year's theme then is a clockwork marching band, and the main feature of this is 18 turning cogs, 4 turntables and 8 turning bandsmen. And it's another all-action entry from the Marketeers Carnival Club from Bridgewater.
From the White Hart Hotel in Bridgewater. Now we're going to see it, now it's going to work. Look at this thing, up and down, round and round. Tremendous engineering. And the music.
This has come Follow the Band from the musical Barnum.
I've heard this before. The choreography is by Teresa Scobie.
The cost of this entry is somewhere around about £10,000, which equals the number of lamps they've used on this particular car.
I think it's true to say that marketeers are desperate to get back into the top frame. They're one of the biggest carnival clubs in the Bridgewater area. They just cannot come up with a winning combination.
Yes, they've got a tremendous membership and tremendous following. Will they do it this year?
The Castle Kerry, from Castle Kerry, is the Kerry Crackpots and their Yokel Wonders. This is a bunch of girls who just turn up, have a tremendous time. They don't care if they win or lose. They're girls of the street, as we might call them.
Well, I think I better choose your words more carefully then, Malcolm, if you don't mind me saying so.
I don't mind you saying so. The club captain is a bundle of fun. She's called Pauline Hanford, and it should be Pauline Handful, really, because she's a great sport. She really is. All these girls, I don't think they've ever won anything really in their lives, so they don't care. They were Diddy men last year, Diddy persons. They're Somerset yokels this year. They dance and sing. Back to the pub, they have a hell of a good time, and this is what Carnival's all about.
O-R.
O-R. O-R, my dear. From the Bridgewater Colts Juvenile Carnival Club, based in Bridgewater, the Indian legend lives on. Last year they entered the carnivals as the Cross Rifles Colts, and they were Walt Disney Fantasy. They won a third and a first and a couple of runners-up, so they've had a good year last year. They're hoping to win this year. A special mention for Matthew Ryder and Phil Pussy for all the work on the cart. And also a special mention to Mr. Mike Ryder, and this card is dedicated to Mike, who unfortunately died this year, age 41. He's greatly missed by all the club, and the carnival will be the loser by his passing. So this is their tribute to Mr. Mike Ryder. The Indian legend lives on. There they go, little kids dancing and jiving away. They're very, very happy. Excellent, excellent idea. We're taking a long look now, because this deserves a long look, is the Domino Carnival Club based in Chard, and their entry this year is Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. They'd like to say a special dedication to Rye Turk, the car designer, and his wife Carol, who had to leave Bridgewater Carnival just prior to the start of the procession and return home to Somerton because their residence had just been burgled. So that's a little dedication to them, true carnivalites. They're both back for Glastonbury, so they say. Ray is at the front, near side of the tractor, and also the oldest male on the cart. So if you can spot him, there he is. There, I've done their dedication. And let's have a good look now. Based on the Andrew Lloyd Webber, Tim Rice musical, which was really resurrected, really, wasn't it? At the Palladium this year by Jason Donovan. Philip Schofield, Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. My good friend Brian, my co-commentator, he's a very great theatrical. Have you ever appeared in this show, Brian?
No, I haven't. Actually, I've played drums for this show. Believe it or not.
That's good. That's good enough.
It started off as about a 15-minute show for junior school, and then it progressed and progressed, and of course now it's a big, big West End hit. And extended its time to over 2 hours.
Are they supposed to shake their skirts like that?
I don't know, really. A bit risque for old Joseph's time.
Well, I think so. But very effective. I'd like to do a special mention here to the police of Glastonbury and Chilkwell and all the area. They're doing a splendid job here. They're keeping control of the massive crowd. And well done. Great. Congratulations to the police. The Hot Rock Carnival Club, based at Gillingham, and it's raining men. It's not raining at all, I'd just like to say now. It's a beautiful evening here. It's Raining Men was a song by the Weather Girls, I believe.
Right? That's right, yeah, the Weather Girls, yeah.
It's raining men.
And yeah. This would please my wife a lot, actually, if it was raining men, but however. Yeah.
Well, there's a few outrageous characters on board this float. There's a hippie nun, there she is. And there's all sorts of weirdos on here. It really is a summary of all things that happen at Gillingham.
Must be Mother Nature at the top there, apparently. That's a nun who ain't got none, presumably, either.
Well, she ain't gonna get none by the look of her either. And they're followed by the Manfitz Carnival Club based at Gillingham. And their entry is Fire and Ice. This is the contrast of two worlds, one red hot and roaring and the other ice cold and freezing. And then they did put a little note there. It says, Malcolm, do you remember all the mud last year? We do remember the mud last year. Brian and I came up to see these people and they build in the most atrocious conditions, believe me. Mud is not the word. But they carry on, it's a little club. And
it's a family concern, but only
right.
Two adults are on this float this year. So here we are, a family concern, it doesn't matter. They're in it, they're enjoying it.
They'd like to say thank you to Bob. Thanks a million, Bob, for all the work you've done in the fundraising and keeping the club together. Great, thank you to Memphis. And I do remember you, and Brian remembers you, and those shoes have never been the same since.
Never been the same.
Yeah. Where is Gillingham?
It's in Dorset.
Just. All the characters from the legendary James Bond films of the 60s. From Russia with Love. And that's what it's called, actually. Themes from the James Bond 007 films. Octopussy. There's Octopussy. And it's the Will Abington Carnival Club. Will Abington just outside of Bridgewater. Guy riding a rocket. And there's License to Kill. Yes. We've swapped over to a Jack in the Box.
This is David Wright. He's a Jack in the Box. And he comes from Eastleigh in Hampshire. So, I mean, that's a fair way to come.
That's got a couple of bounds and he's here, isn't he? These are the springs, sitting on the spring. The Spirit of Arabia. And this has been winning a lot of entries for the Harlequins Carnival Club. They were the South Federation champions, I believe. I'm not sure. Let me just check on my little... no, they weren't. I keep mixing these up.
They're actually they're the first club to win
yes,
the first
they were.
They, all the time
they
in
were,
the South Somerset Circuit.
They
so
were
you
the
are
champions.
Right.
Yes, I'm sorry. Yeah. I I'd like to say a special hello to Russell Manley, who's confined a wheelchair at the end of last year, age 39. All the members have worked extremely hard this year to build a winner for him, and it has been a winner. And the music is...
He's Holding Out for a Hero by Bonnie Tyler.
I was about to say that. There's a lot of our old friends on this float. We know them all well. We've seen this club grow and grow and grow. They're one of the giants of the Southern Federation now. I mean, they've traveled about 200 or 300 miles with this float over the... since the early part of the summer, when the Southern Federation Carnivals take part, right now into the Somerset Federation. I believe there's about two more and then it's over.
Summer,
Yes, the South Somerset floats have to actually last a lot longer time than any of the other Mid-Somerset floats do.
The Magnum Carnival Club at Blandford, and their entry is Money, Money, Money. Last year they were Kites. The music is Money, Money, Money by ABBA. It's not been a good year for, there have been continual generator problems with this club on the Wessex circuit, not a different circuit altogether. They hope to get around Glastonbury, all their lights working as they failed halfway around last year. Well, so far, so good.
This is a relatively small club. They only have 8 adult members who do all the building, lighting and the costumes, and that's really what Carnival's all about. Everyone in helping, doing everything, and basically this is their hour, this is their moment when they appear in front of thousands of people, and that's the enjoyment.
Who was it? Andy Warhol said everybody's famous for 15 minutes.
Yeah, when's it your turn?
Ryan, the Wills Carnival Club of Bridgewater, and their entry this year is...
This is the Law Circle of the Magna Chi. It's all about the future. Basically, the theme is the female of the race is actually the dominant people following a Holocaust. So these are the ladies who are the dominant. Beautiful costumes, beautiful makeup. And on the floor, you can see the defeated. This is one of the most spectacular floats in the procession this evening. They've gained many prizes in this year's round of carnivals, and perhaps tonight will be no exception. You might be able to pan down and see some of the makeup, which is, there it is. Now that's a superb example of the makeup, which takes a long time to apply. And that, believe it or not, is mortician's wax and latex. Now just look at that. Superb. These are the defeated ones. Tremendous entry from the Wills Carnival Club based in Bridgewater. Following on from that, many hands make light work. And this is Robert Bubier from Will Abington. Very much a European theme. Lots of hands with the European flag surrounding.
excellent entry there. Tracy Allen from Froome, and a work of art. She's obviously the Laughing Cavalier, which could be called a smirk of art.
Well, it could be, but I'd rather not, if you don't mind.
We're looking for a great character now. My man's looking for him. He's going to turn and give me a smile. Yes, if we can. It's a man called Jack Crowther, who's been walking the streets of Somerset for years. He's there he is. That's Jack Crowther. He's been in Carnival for more years than I would care to carve in a tree. Jack is about 1,000-year-old. He lives in a jar of pickles. They bring him out. They bring him out for Carnival. Jack is a great, great Carnival. Carnival light. And this is the club to which he belongs, or to who belongs to which. It's the Centurions Carnival Club of Bridgewater. Jack Crowther has been a stalwart member now for more years than you can ever account for. And their entry this year is the Forbidden City of Peking. More gold, more sequins. Beautiful finish float disc, beautiful floor, beautiful costumes, and one of the best entries that the Centurions Club has done for years and years. And my heartfelt congratulations to the Centurions Carnival Club and the Forbidden City of Peking.
Yes, I echo everything that you've just said, Malcolm, and really is, and getting a lot of appreciation from the crowd too. Beautiful headdress there. Please don't talk to me like that, if you don't mind.
That's the way to do it. That's the name of the entry. It's from the Jester's Carnival Club of Shepton. It's based on all the fun characters from our childhood, when we used to see the Punch and Judy man at every beach. Burnham-on-Sea was like a mecca for Punch and Judy men, and Western Supermare, of course. And here they are, the Punch and Judy. Punch, Judy, the butcher, the sausage, the crocodile, the baby, they're all here. Punchinello, I believe it was. This is based on the Italian character, wasn't it? Brought over to England and a long, long time ago.
Yes, indeed.
So this is the more you look at it, it's an enormous entry, isn't it? I mean, you just consider it to be a comic float, and then you look along, it's about 100 feet of the thing, and it really is all full of action and light.
That's right, there's an awful lot going on here.
From the Marina Sydenham Juvenile Carnival Club, and their entry this year is Russian-ish. This is based on the pre-91 revolution, we might say, because that's what it was when Russia was Russia, USSR. Now it's all split up, of course, and these are based on the traditional costumes of Russia, USSR. You understand what I'm saying, Brian?
I do indeed, yes. Don't worry about it. I think this is tremendous, because this is a junior club, as Malcolm quite rightly says, putting an awful lot in. This is a tremendous standard for a junior club. £2,000 the cost, 2,000 lamps used, and my goodness, an awful lot of work. The float was built by only 5 adults: Richard Humphrey, Chris Higgs, John Parsons, Trevor Palmer and Rod Waite, and they really have put an awful lot into this one. And they've now got a permanent shed to work in the dry, and I think it shows, because this is a very, very good entry indeed.
Yes, beautifully choreographed as well. And we're going to pick up a lovely little girl dancing in pink, I hope. There she is. She's really in the pink. I think her makeup could have been a little better.
Yes, we've got a little line there, which might have been well...
From the Bohemians Carnival Club of Bridgewater, and their entry this year is Hans Christian Andersen's Fairy Tales.
And depicted upon this car, float, various of the 168 stories that Hans Christian Andersen wrote, and first published in 1835 and translated into more than 100 languages.
It was a childlike fantasy with a penetrating wisdom from stories like The Princess and the Pen, The Emperor's New Clothes, The Ugly Duckling, The Snow Queen, and The Red Shoes. And at the back there, you can see coming into view is almost certainly the Snow Queen.
And one of the most fantastic, beautiful pink castles I've ever seen. Oh, this is the Snow Queen. The Pop-In Carnival Club, they're holding out for a hero, the Pop-In, which is Tatworth, of course. And it's a big mouse. The theme is a mouse caught in a mouse trap, and the other mouse are trying to rescue it from a big fat cat. A big fat cat is at the front, and all the mice are all the way around. There's a big fat cat. The music again, Bonnie Tyler. You get a little abstract idea like this, they have a lot of fun doing their thing. The cats and the mice.
The perennial story of cats and mice always be chasing each other.
Fighting cats and dogs from the little billies. These are all the little kids of the King Billy Carnival Club, which is going to be coming along in just a moment.
And this is their introduction to Carnival, and they're having a great time.
When I say King Billy, I mean the King William Carnival Club, yeah. Based at the Ye Queen's Head. Personally, I think this is one of the most beautiful floats that I've seen in a long, long time. The King William Carnival Club of Glastonbury, Entre la Cirque, a French circus theme. Look at the costumes, look at the makeup, look at the positioning of these people. This is truly magnificent.
They'd like to make a special mention to Jill and Tony Mead for making all the headdresses, and I must admit they've done a fabulous job with these.
Yeah, we're going to try and pick up as many of these people as we can, because it really is fantastic.
This depicts the big parade before the show in the big top to follow. And you get all the atmosphere of the circus with this one. My goodness, you do.
There's a clown there and a costume on a clown.
Absolutely superb costumes.
Absolutely. I'd be proud to wear it. There it is. Look at the work. I'm looking for the maker of the costumes. She must be here somewhere. Oh, boy, Steve Shepherd designed it. Yes, Linda Gellerford, Margaret Robbins, Nan Gould, and Ashley Bamwell. Congratulations. The best costumes in the carnival procession, and that's my opinion.
I agree with that.
The Vagabonds Carnival Club of Bridgewater and their Eastern Mystique. And it's based on 1001 Arabian Nights. I think the float designer, the cart designer, is Graham Palmer, who's been a designer for many, many years now. And I think this is one of the best finished carts that you'll see.
Yes, always tremendous attention to detail from Vagabonds. This year, no exception. They've actually got a new permanent home for their cart. It's under construction at the Hickney Point Social Club in Bridgewater, which obviously makes sure that they can keep everything really dry and absolutely superb condition before it comes out on the road.
That's Robert Heath going around there. His father is Colin Heath. His grandfather was in Carnival, and his father was in. So this is the fourth generation of Carnivalite we just saw going around there. A little snippet of information you'll be interested in, I know. Special mention as well to Terry Britton and Jesse Howes, both of whom have done 30 years apiece in Carnival. That's a lifetime almost.
That's right, and they still live to tell the tale.
The Ashcombe Carnival Club. They're monsters doing a monster mash of sorts. And that's exactly what it's called, the Monster Mash. They're based at Western Supermare. Last year they were Waterloo Checkmate. This year they're in a Monster Mash.
Pick your favourite monster. There's probably that particular character on this particular float.
Actually, my wife's home this evening.
Oh, dear Malcolm. That's really below the belt, that. I'm sorry, but I don't think that's right. She's a lovely lady.
I've got a face on this guy.
That looks more like your wife.
And this is an old guy doing a solo Michael Jackson thing at the back. The Aces Carnival Club, they're from Burnham-on-Sea, and they're the Laughing Policeman based on the old music hall character created and sung for years and years by Charles Penrose.
Not Charles Mim.
It's a little tongue-tied there, Brian. I'm sorry about that. Look at this guy. And this is going down well with the police around here. They're all smiling. The police have been very, very good. I've said it before. I'll say it again. The police have been very, very good up here. And they keep it in good order. You can imagine that these floats take up most of the roads around the area. The roads are closed, but the traffic still has to go somewhere. It's a nightmare for the police. And as long as they can keep laughing like this, they'll be all right.
Said that while building this float, the axle broke, which is obviously a pretty big handicap, really. But they welded it together again, and off they go.
I used to play this on Uncle Matt, children's favourite, didn't they, all the time? A particular favourite of mine and Brian's is this next entry. It's from the Masqueraders Carnival Club of Glastonbury. It's called Chen, which is Chinese for dragon. It is the most sensational float that I've seen for a long, long time. I don't think that it's got the recognition that it deserves. My opinion only. I speak for myself alone. I'm not here to criticize judges. Judge for yourself. Look at the roof rippling. There's the dragon snorting his fire and the choreography, the music. I think this is excellent. Judge for yourself. Chen from the Masqueraders Carnival Club of Glastonbury.
I agree with you, Malcolm. This is just sensational. It really is good. And if you pay attention to the roof, you can see it oscillating as it goes like a sort of multi-legged spider, if you like, from one end to the other. There it is. But that's not all. Dragons turning in the middle, lots of wonderful choreography and movement. Costumes are terrific. Dragons are turning. Just tremendous.
Yes, congratulations to Richard Collins, the model maker, and the designers, Mike Kent and Richard Collins, of course. A special thanks to Caroline Kent and the club members, and the costumes of Alison Goodman, Sue Fricker, Karen Pebbercombe, Narina Scott, Sally Herford. Sensational entry that I think has not got the recognition that it deserves, and this is no way of my criticizing the judges. They look at it differently than I do.
This is probably the maximum size allowed, 100 foot long, 11 foot wide, and 17 foot 6 high.
We got a tin man here, and this is...
That's Richard Palmer from Whirl, Western Superman.
And he's got a lady with him who we can't ID, unfortunately. We'll just say that's the tin man and his tin girl. Actually, I think she's with him. She's got a tin opener around. From the Pariah Carnival Club, they're based in Bridgewater, and it's a quest for Merlin. And I'm so, so happy to see these. They've had some tremendously bad luck in previous carnivals when all the lights have failed. Tonight's the lights are up and running, and we're going to get as much as we can. There's a white dragon at the front, and this is the story of the evil white dragon at the front, and Arthur there pulling the sword from the stone. There's the beautiful Val, the old crow. There's Arthur pulling the sword from the stone. Merlin the magician It really is the story of Merlin. Was it a myth? Sword and a stone. Excalibur, I believe the sword was.
That's right.
Was it true? Was it a myth? We don't know. Do you know what a myth is?
Now you tell me what a myth is, Malcolm.
A myth. That's a lady moth.
What's that got to do with Excalibur?
Nothing at all. Nothing at all.
Okay.
An excellent entry from Pariah, who last year with a sick new colleagues, you may remember. The YMCA Carnival Club of Bridgewater, they're based at the River Parrot Inn at Bridgewater, and they're perfection. A collection of old alley cats put together there, cleaned up, combed up, a couple of flea collars put on them, and they're ready to rock and roll. They're dancing in the streets by Martha and the Vandellas. This is it. This is the perfection from the YMCA Carnival Club. Oh, I love this music from the 60s. I mean, cats in Bridgewater danced a little else. I was in the King William with him just a little while ago, that particular cat. Beautiful makeup, good costumes on here. I think a little more thought in the float may have brought a little more prizes. It's abstract in the extreme, I think, is fair comment. I'm not criticizing once again, but...
Oh, they're enjoying themselves, though.
It doesn't scream cat at me, does it?
But that artwork's very good on the back.
Oh,
the
yes,
illustration
excellent.
Is terrific.
Excellent. This is just George's Carnival Club from Sturminster Newton, and they're a washout. These are the Beach Boys and the Fat Boys wipeout music, and this is what you do when the surf's up. Hey, surf's up, get your surfboard. No, get your ironing board. Let's get down to the ocean, do a little bit of laundry, shall we? And there they are. And they tell me that the curtain thing, not the curtain, the washing lines, the rotary wash lines are all up for sale afterwards. Anybody interested, get in touch with the Just George's Carnival Club. Make a good offer, you can buy all the wash baskets and wash lines. A little bit of fun is a wipeout, should be, but it's a washout. The Wind Whistle Carnival Club of Western Supermare and their beautiful entry, the Venetian Masquerade.
Yes, if there's something that really features amongst tableaus, it's the costumes. And this one is no exception. Wonderful costumes, wonderful makeup. And despite what might appear to be a very plain cart, as soon as you put people on it, then it really does look something.
Of course, in Venice, if you go to Venice, the masks are a very great feature of all the balls in Venice. And the masks are very famous. And this is a mask ball of Venice. Going across the Bridge of Sighs, maybe. The jester. This is also a very famous entry of in Venice. There's a lot of jesters. Or harlequins, I believe they are. Harlequins.
That's right. Don't forget, these people don't have a nice cozy dressing room to get dressed up in and made up in. They're normally doing this in the back of cars or vans or something. And so therefore, it's very difficult for them to make themselves look really good under those sort of circumstances. But they really do. Tremendous work.
Yes, there you get just a taste of the makeup and the costumes. It's all personified there in that trio. Excellent. Right now I'm going to give a mention to all the caravanners who have come to on a club rally to watch the Glastonbury Carnival tonight. So a special mention and a special hello to all the caravanners. The Return of the Red Dragon. This is from the Fleet Air Arm Museum, Yeovilton.
This is the Red Baron, actually, if I may.
What did I say?
I think you said the Red Dragon.
Oh, I'm thinking of somewhere else, actually. The Red Baron, I'm sorry. We all know the Red Baron and Snoopy, the the character from the Schultz cartoon Peanuts. There's Snoopy just in the second aeroplane and he hunts down the Red Baron.
They'd like to pay a very special thanks to the Domino Carnival Club of Chard, who built the float for them. Obviously we all need a little bit of help, but fame from them from the Domino Carnival Club.
And the music by the Red Barons and the Hot Shots, the Magnificent Men. The return of the Red Baron. This is their first year in Carnival and we hope to see a lot more of these. That's two firsts. Here's one we haven't seen before. The Bay Jays of Gillingham present Sleeping Beauty. And I'll tell you a little secret now. I was in a pantomime last year called Sleeping Beauty.
And you were wonderful, Michael.
It says features a fairy tale.
Can you give me the £10 now?
A fairy tale castle with an old lady spinning. Sleeping Beauty is asleep and she's about to be awoken by her prince. Watched by the good fairies and the bad fairies, the king, the queen and the palace staff.
Would you like to tell us what role you played last year, Malcolm?
I was the idiot.
Well, fancy that. They say that this particular entry is assembled in the open air farmyard and everything is handmade, even the spinning wheel. And they'd like to thank Doug Perryfield for that.
Yes. And what a beautiful Sleeping Beauty she is. Sleeping Beauty is 14-year-old Corrine Webb. There she is. The prince is 18-year-old Paul Herrefield. There's the king and the queen. The king...
We'd like to specially mention Geoffrey Paul, who made the gates and the crowns, and Len Fenning of the Kerry Comedians, who lends the generator each year.
Oh, I know Len Fenning is 87 years old, still walks around. That's excellent. Sleeping Beauty by the Bay Jays, one of their best entries for a long, long time. The British Flag Carnival Club, based at the British Flag Inn in Bridgewater, and their entry this year, the Circus Spectacular. Brian, this is a particular favourite of yours, I know. And in fact, we love all the circus entries this year. Circus has been done beautifully, hasn't it?
It has indeed. And whilst the other one we've just seen was a tableau, this is in fact the complete opposite, because this is all action. And it really is very spectacular indeed. You'll see that the base of this car is really sort of three circus, if you like, clown cars. And then above that, you've got sea lions and the clowns themselves. And the sea lions are balancing sort of cone objects on their noses and they're going round. Very clever indeed. All action, all go. Tremendously spectacular entry from the British Flag Carnival Club.
The guy there we can see under the very end umbrella spinning round, waving his, doing his dance now. He's actually part of our team actually, is Mark Higgins. I don't know if we're going to individualize Mark at all, but there he is. That's Mark Higgins. He was part of our team a long, long time ago, and he left us and he joined the circus. They got him harnessed up there, of course, as a safety feature now. There's been a lot of terrible injuries in Carnival. It's very safety conscious now. Excellent, excellent. The circus from the British Flag Carnival Club.
Actually, they've done a very good treatment of the generator there. You can see it. It's the old circus tent at the back there and effectively covers this huge generator powering all the lights.
The music. I'm singing in the rain. Fortunately, there is no rain this year. The entry is called Come Rain or Shine. It's from the Hillview Juvenile Carnival Club, based at Burnham-on-Sea. Sing it! That's right.
There's not any rain, but we've got rainbows and clouds and suns as well on this particular entry.
And daughters. They're based at the Somerset and Dorset Inn, Burnham-on-Sea. The youngest member of this float is Jason Grattan. He's 5 years old.
Hey! typically tropical. The name is familiar, the treatment is different. The Western Zoyland Carnival Club.
This is the sort of entry that'll warm up the coldest night.
Last year they were fairground attractions, you may remember. They won second last year at Shepton Mallet and at Glastonbury.
This is again a very well constructed entry. Particularly keen on the palm trees here. They've really done a fantastic job with them. And nicely coordinated costumes with the colour of the float. It really does blend in very well indeed. Well done to Western Zoyland Carnival Club.
Yes, they're warming us all up. We're all enjoying jigging around with that. That's the lovely costumes you can see. Actually, this procession is flowing very, very well for Glastonbury. It's the Glastonbury and Chilkwell Carnival, but it's actually in the town of Glastonbury, which is not the easiest for these gigantic floats to negotiate. And there's been very, very few stoppages. We're taking a sneak preview now at the county champions elect. I don't think I'll be wrong in saying that. They've won everywhere, and in my opinion, they probably will win everywhere. The Minstrel Melody from the Gremlins Carnival Club. They've built an enormous train, and this entry is fantastic. We're trying to get some long shots, some wide shots, as much as we can. We're going to go big on this one. Here we go. Minstrel Melody from the Gremlins Carnival Club, and I predict that this will be the county champions.
I agree with you, Malcolm, and believe it or not, there are 12,500 lights on this particular entry. 1 megawatt of power is generated to supply all the power necessary for this particular float. So next time you go into your superstore and buy a little packet of 3 bulbs, think how much this lot cost.
There you go, look at that shot. Let's hold this for as long as we can, Mr. Director. Oh, that's great. Is that not great? 1 megawatt is about what it takes to light up 3/4 of Glastonbury, and they're dragging this around. Oh, excellent, excellent.
This is going to take some beating, isn't it, Malcolm?
Nothing will beat this, Brian. I said this from day one. The moment I saw it, I said, this is something special. And they're singing and dancing, and they're happy because they know they're on a winner. And you get this feeling, you get this buzz. People in Carnival know. They know, I know, you know, everyone knows. This is a winner.
It certainly is.
I think a special mention should go to the float designers, Paul Redmond. And the captain this year is David West. He must be very, very proud of his gang. We're very lucky because he's actually stopped here for a little while. So we can see. That's the generator unit there. It's a Mississippi showboat. Even that's working. Oh, sensational. Ladies and gentlemen, they were the champions, and they still are the champions. Meanwhile, up the road, the show goes on. The Pratton's Carnival Club and their presentation, the Bannerman, all the way from Midsummer Norton.
Lots of banners and pom-poms being waved here. And of course, Bannerman was a hit for the group Blue Mink back in, I think it was 1971. This is, of course, fronted by Madeline Bell and Roger Cook.
Yeah, I'd like to say that Alan and Melanie got married this year. They met at Glastonbury Carnival 4 years ago. Oh, Cupid, where are you?
you don't want any Cupids.
No, I don't.
Cupids have done for you, no, I think. They've actually made a reappearance this year because the Pratons did not take part last year due to lack of members and money. But they raised some money, they've got themselves together and they're back again, and that's what we like to see.
That's right, they're up and rolling and looking good. The Bannerman from the Pratons Carnival Club of Midsummer Norton. And let's hope we see Pratons Carnival Club next year. The MCC Toy Town Fire Brigade. I'm told this is the High Rollers Carnival Club of Bridgewater on a trip to Trumpton. Last year they did a Pirate's Life, 1991 style. This year they're a trip to Trumpton, 1992 style. And my friend Brian has a O-level in Trumpton. If you could just tell us all about Trumpton.
Well, yeah, I don't know about an O-level, but I certainly knew about Pew Pew, Barney McGrew, Cuthbert Dibble, and Grub. Will that do? Although this, I must say, is a Toy Town Fire Brigade. It's the Macintosh Carnival Club in Colford. Sorry, Macintosh.
I thought we might have given you the wrong information at the beginning there.
We shall doubtless return to Trumpton
a little later on. In the meantime, my old man's a dustman. This is the Pilgrims Carnival Club. And this is a great fun. I love this one. From Puritan Inn in Puritan Inn in Puritan. Last year they were Monkey Business. This year they're based on Lonnie Donegan's great hit record, My Old Man's a Dustman. There they are.
Yes, anything to do with a laugh and good times are always due for the Puritan Pilgrims.
Yes, special mention to Simon Putty, Tim Goddard and Roy Goddard for Clark Design.
And on here somewhere is Debbie Riley, who was recently given the title of Miss Breen, 1992. Put forward to Miss UK, but did not win. Which one is Debbie Riley? Is it him?
well, Miss Breen, it might well be. There's lovely graphics there on the generator unit. We're looking at Merv's Mania on Manic Maori's Merv's Carnival Club, and their Manic Maori's 5-0, and the Maori Celeste is the name of the ship they're in.
Absolute load of nutters, without a doubt.
Actually, you've got to know Merv's to love them, and if you know them, you couldn't possibly love them. They're doing all the Maori...
And they're trying to do a version of the Haka, really, but I got a feeling that tongue has only been used to sort of sinking pints or something equally as
well, that's what they're at Carnival for, isn't it? Last year they were the 30s firefighters, and they got a couple of prizes which surprised everyone, including the judges.
In your picture now, the Minster Carnival Club from Axminster with their Pink Panthers Cadillac. Now, if you ever envisage what a Pink Panthers Cadillac entry would look like, probably wouldn't be like this, but they've been very clever, because what they've done is they put revolving Pink Panthers and revolving Inspector Clouseurs together, and little cars at the bottom, and they produced a very effective entry indeed.
Yes, great fun entry, just so it shows what you can do if you explode your mind a little, pick on an idea and go for it. The music, Pink Cadillac by Natalie Cole. They say while building the float, they had an electrical float and electrocuted one of the farmer's cows. Oops. Well, we're sorry to hear about that, but we're glad that you're all on the road. The Pink Panther Cadillac, and it's all the way from Durham. Durham, 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 Durham.
That's a bad joke.
I know. Okay. The designer and model maker is Nigel Phillips with a little help from his friends. There you go, the Mr. Carnival Club. and the Pink Panthers Cadillac.
And they had a fire when they were burning this, so they managed to extinguish all the flames, but new wiring had to be put in after that, but here they are.
Yo, the old Blake Edwards movies, we miss them very, very much. Sumo's on tour.
Not sure whether it's sumos or a lot of pregnant Japanese. I'm not sure which it is really.
Sumos, I recognize all they got. Tama, Hasa, Tomataka. The one on the front is probably the dump truck.
Still, you don't get cold, do you, wearing that?
I don't think so. Last year, their entries. I bet it's just identifying first. It's the Martin's Carnival Club of Midsummer Norton. And last year, they were Help. This year, they're Sumos. He's too sexy for his shirt.
I must admit, if the sumos don't look too authentic, the Japanese writing on the side certainly does.
Actually, yeah, the sumos in Japan are actually treated almost as gods, aren't they?
Certainly are. They get paid more money than you and I. That's
absolutely,
sure.
That's true. But there, they're in better shape than you and I. The Gorgon's Carnival Club at Old MacDonald's Farm. Everybody knows the song about Old MacDonald's. Everybody loves it. They're based at the Waldergrave Arms. Probably a Chute and Mendip. Old MacDonald had a farm. Do you know his postcode?
No, but you're going to tell me just the same.
Yes, I am. Old MacDonald's Farm postcode is E-I-E-I-O.
Well, thank you, Malcolm.
Thank you. You're very welcome.
I think we've had to say a special mention to Paul Phipps, who is on this float with a broken leg.
Oh, my God.
I can't see anybody with a broken leg, but doubtless he's there.
Well, somebody with a broken leg walking by the side of the float.
Perhaps he is not in at all, then.
That's a good idea. That's a good float. It's a good split level. Good old MacDonald. Everybody knows that. That's old MacDonald's daughter, Miss MacDonald. The music, Das Sprach Zarthusa. And the entry is the Statues of Rock from the Shambles Carnival Club of Shepton Mallet. And a very, very clever entry this. Very clever indeed. All these artists, so the features on the float are actually the kings of rock and roll and the statues. Elvis, there's Freddie Mercury we're looking at. We're trying to ID the others. That's
Janet Jackson.
Janet Jackson, of course, sorry. Boy George. Michael Jackson just behind him. Elton John. Had a clever idea. That's Elton John. I suppose in time, as time goes on, that these statues will be erected, won't they? Because they are very famous people.
Very much so.
The Colts Carnival Club, based at Froome, and they're on the warpath. More juveniles, I'm happy to say. I love to see these little kids enjoying themselves. And more Indians.
Yeah, this depicts the red Indians on the warpath chasing away the white man off their sacred land.
Absolutely. Good luck to them. Yeah, I remember Buffalo Bill. You know, he had three ears.
He did?
Yes, a left ear, a right ear, and a wild front ear.
You should never ask, man.
It don't get better,
it's
does
pathetic,
it?
Huh?
Great models of horses here from the Colts Carnival Club. And a special thanks to Alan Brunt for letting them, these kids build on his land. The costumes were made by Jane Chalmers, who's got four grandchildren on the float. And as they slowly disappear into the sunset, we turn around and what do we see? It's old Woody Woodpecker. And it's Here Comes Woody from the Watchfield Carnival Club, just outside of Highbridge, the Watchfield Inn, on the Woodpecker's Ball.
We've got some music here that has been professionally remixed by the Beehive Studio.
I recognise Knock on Wood. And Woody Woodpecker still, of course.
And they'd like to say special thanks to Duncan Squire for the sound system, Len Stevens and my mother for the artwork, and Martin Burgess for building the generator car.
And they're all important. They're all very, very important. We move on now to the Buccaneers Carnival Club. They're from Burnham-on-Sea. And their entry is called Money. It's a European spinner. Another car. Casino entry.
Do you gamble, Malcolm? Do you? I mean, are you a gambling
too? Oh, yes, I am a gambler, man.
Are you really?
My life's been a gamble.
No wonder you've got so much money, man.
Some you win, some you don't win. But if you're a gambler, you don't lose. These people are a little tired, actually. They've been dancing for about an hour and a half now. It's a rich man's world, have no doubts about that. Money, 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 the great sound of the great group ABBA disappearing into the distance. And we come on now with a tableau entry, a very sensational tableau entry from the Luckington Carnival Club, based at Froome, of the myth and the magic, the Arthurian legend, Merlin, of course, again. And this takes us through the various stages of Merlin and some of the events in the life of Merlin. So now we can see it. Summing the elements is the first part, the Age of Enlightenment the second part, where they're three together, the Mort d'Arthur, the death of Arthur, the Vigil of Sir Galahad, that's Sir Galahad and his vigil, King Arthur up above him, Sir Lancelot, the quest for the Holy Grail, everything is there. It's the entire myth, magic, and legend, the Arthurian legend. Great character face there, Brian.
Yes, indeed, and a very original type entry as well, all in silver.
Last year was very original as well. They did Whodunit based on the Cluedo board game, you may remember. The Kirk's Cronies now, and these are presented to you by the Kerry Comedians Carnival Club, based on Captain Kirk and all the crew and characters of the Starship Enterprise from the Gene Roddenberry TV series. You can see the captain there, and it's a guy with the ears.
Mr. Spock.
Mr. Spock.
That's right.
Yes, he'll come around the corner now and you'll see him.
Well, I really hope that I don't get Klingons on my starboard bow, actually. That's all I can say,
very
really.
Painful. They can be electronically removed now.
I'm very pleased to hear it.
Oh, I'm all ears, Spock. We've got them all there. Kirk, Spock, Dr. McCoy at the back. Klingons. Beam me up, Scotty.
And on a nice pair of legs or two.
There's actually Dr. McCoy. I don't really know who that is.
Yeah.
That's McCoy's surgery there. And Scotty at the back. Scotty's power gen. There they are, generating their power there. Captain and Scotty. Do you remember that? Beam me up, Scotty. Great, six movies. Countless TV series, all based on the same characters. But never, never done as well as the Kerry Comedians. Kirk's Cronies. And a special mention again to Len Fennon, 87-year-old and still walking around with a carnival float. Good to see you, Len. The Phantoms Carnival Club off Glastonbury, and their entry is Viva Las Vegas. Well, we've seen an idea like this before, but this is a different treatment. They're based at the Glastonbury and Railway Inn, or Wind's Front Room, it says here. and the designers Paul Stillwell and Dave Ford. It's a gambling theme. The cards built to resemble a roulette table, and court cards from a line down the centre.
Well, they must have got very cosy in Wynn's front room with this lot rehearsing. Sure.
All the cards down the centre of the card were painted by the father of one of the members, Mr. Dave Ford. Excellent painting. Well done, Dave.
And they say they've tried a new idea to produce a cart without a roof on this year, and they hope that it'll give pleasure to all who see it. Well, I'm sure they've done that.
Good choreography as well. They've got it all together there. Excellent entry from the Phantoms Carnival Club of Mier. Here's a nice long shot of a good club. Good club, good members, good friends. I know them all, I love them all. The Britannia Carnival Club of Wincanton. And they're walking on sunshine. And they've actually won two first prizes this year. And they say they think it's perhaps it was because Sarah's black knickers were spotted around her ankle. Oh, now we know Sarah, and then she's not that type of girl. She's a lovely, lovely girl.
I don't know what some people do to win, you know.
Yes, well, I would never do such a thing.
No, well, you needn't, Malcolm, if I might say so. Anyway, whatever the weather is, and it's November, and it's really a little bit rainy here.
Yes, it's just started to rain, Brian. You may tell the people this. They're sitting home by their fire, a glass in their hand, a hot cocoa by the side, a few biscuits. It started to rain here. It's a November carnival in Somerset. It's raining. It's no great surprise.
But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because we're walking on sunshine. Let's think about the summer and those good, hot, sunny days.
Yes. I think of little else.
I thought you weren't going to mention little else.
I love her. I know. This club is based at the Horse Pond Inn at Castle Kerry. The club designer was Martin Cabell. And the club captain is Graham Bashford. Excellent. I know these guys. I love them all. It's a family concern. You can see the little kids there dancing. The mothers, the fathers, the little kids. They're all great. And I'm sad that it's raining. Truly I am.
But you're in the best place because you can watch this in the comfort of your own home.
And it's really... It's just beginning to rain very heavily now. Walking on sunshine at Britannia Carnival Club of Wincanton.
Just to emphasise the warm and hot theme, this is the Waterside Carnival Club from High Littleton with Some Like It Hot. This features monsters and skulls and flames, and they're based at the Welton Rovers Football Club.
I like this, to pick up the happy laughing faces of the girls. I've never seen such a happy club as this.
Yeah, they're all laughing.
Look at them. Bring on her face. She's having a lot of a good time. And they're a very happy little bunch of ladies and gentlemen. Hey, you can't paint smiles like that on. It's a cold November evening now. It's turning into a miserable evening with the rain coming down. They're at the very beginning of a 2-mile procession, and they're laughing and enjoying themselves. They don't care about the rest of the evening. Thunderbirds are gold. This is the Highbridge Young Farmers Carnival Club. Back in the 60s, these puppet people were very much in vogue. They disappeared from the face of the earth, and now they're back with a vengeance. Look at the rain coming down there. That was a good shot. Thunderbird characters are selling like hotcakes. They're following now on TV. And this is the Highbridge Young Farmers Carnival Club interpretation of all the characters we see and we love from the Thunderbirds.
Thank you.
Hucky Duck Carnival Club and their presentation. Just had a slight delay there. They had to hold on because an ambulance has just pulled through, which gives us a little longer to see all the characters and the costumes. The Hucky Duck Carnival Club of Colford, I believe, will be this year's county champions, and their entry is excellent. It's the greatest show on earth.
Well, it certainly might be the greatest show in this carnival. This is absolutely superb. Just take all this in. There is so much to see here.
I see it's they're wobbling about a little bit because the tractor's having trouble getting a grip. That's better. Let's get some close-ups of these people. On the elephant, Becky Schwartz, Lynn Cooler. On the trapeze, Sonia Wright, Sarah James, the tightrope walkers, John Searle, Sue Watts, Helen Searle, unicyclers, Twinny Williams, there's the cannonman, Captain Zero, Simon Collins. An excellent, excellent entry there. And there's the band at the back.
Absolutely superb, that.
The Moore Clangers Carnival Club, Snow White's Winter Workers. Yeah, they're from Moore Lynch. And it's Snow White on ice. A very revealing Snow White at the front. Whoops. There you go, Snow White's a little ice. Little ice, yes, that's right. Snow White, a little ice, a little snow, and a little bit of fun from the Moore Clangers Carnival Club of Moore Lynch. There's the wicked stepmother who sent them all, poor Snow White, into the forest. There's a lovely, lovely entry now from the White Hart Carnival Club of Midsummer Norton and Alice, based on all the characters from the Lewis Carroll's novels, Alice in Wonderland and Alice Through the Looking Glass. There's Alice listening to the stories. Pretty soon we'll see all the characters unveiled, the Mad Hatter and the little field mouse. There's the Mad Hatter, Tweedledum, Tweedledee, right at the bottom there in the picture. There we are, that's another little Alice, a beautiful blonde Alice, having her tea.
I think that's Queen of the Queen of Hearts, is it?
She's looking duly solemn. What a lovely Alice.
Very pretty Alice.
What a tea party.
It's the Mad Hatter.
Off we go again, the procession's on the move again. And Alice in Wonderland will gently slip from our view with the Queen of Hearts playing croquet with the birds, whatever birds they were. Brian, help me, what birds were they?
Oh, don't ask me.
Flamingos. They were flamingos.
No, they were flamingos. See, your memory didn't let you down after all, did it?
Absolutely pouring down now, but nothing can quench the spirits of these people. They're on the streets of London. It's the Avalon Carnival Club, based in Glastonbury, and they're singing "The Sunny Side of the Street."
Yeah, you have to stretch your imagination a little far, but that doesn't matter.
They're based at the Tor Leisure Centre, and this is a London street scene set in the early 1900s. Who's your lady friend, lovey? And they're getting very, very wet there. It's a very narrow roof and they're not all undercover. And there's an authentic 1900 digital watch I see. Whoops. But I admire their fortitude, their courage, and their sheer entertainment value because they're lifting us now. Congratulations, Avalon Carnival Club, you've made me smile. Thank you very much.
This is Honiton Young Farmers Club behind the nursery door. Very colourful entry from this really very, very pleasant club indeed. We went down to see them once and I must admit they are a really jolly bunch of people. And they really do enjoy themselves. They might be getting soaking wet, but that doesn't matter. They'd like to say a special thanks to Brian Howard for hours of hard work getting the float on the road. And this year, this float will have travelled 850 miles over 4 months to take part in 14 carnival processions. So I think they would have a special award for that alone. Well done, Honiton Young Farmers Club.
The Chameleon Carnival Club, well, unfortunately they've lost all their lighting, but they'll still carry on. They're based in Froome and it's the story of Willow. And they're getting a lot of applause there. Fortunately our lights can pick them up. The Willow pattern, Brian?
Yeah, Willow pattern was a decorative design done in a pseudo-Chinese manner, of course, introduced around 1780. It's actually English and it's best known of all the transfer printed designs.
And there we go, and with the weather just slowly closing in amongst around us and the crowd drifting away, it's been a very, very good carnival. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you can pick out the winners. After the credits of Rome, you'll be able to see the winning prizes. This is me, Malcolm Jones, the voice of Carnival, saying good night to you all. Good night. Hope you enjoyed yourself.
And this is me, Brian Epps, saying likewise. I hope you really have enjoyed this particular carnival. I think it's been spectacular and I think it has been a really tremendous evening's entertainment. Thank you very much indeed for joining us.
On behalf of Swift TV, good night. God bless you all.
Good night.